to the mall with a plan in mind about what you're going to buy, but ended up walking out with two extra t-shirts because you see it's on sale. Well, the fact is, fashion industry targeted this mindset because the clothing are cheaper, so we think it's okay to buy more. On average, an American spends $1,800 on fashion apparel each year, according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics on August 2017. Clothing to us, it's a necessity. It provides us warmth and personal identity, cultural identity, and often act as a statement for us. For this topic, I conducted extensive research on several environmental organization websites, as well as Center for Disease Control and Prevention, and government congressional document about our economy. Therefore, I'm credible to talk about this topic. I'm presenting the fact about this industry in hope that I will convince you all to become a smarter consumer, because fast fashion industry is not good for our environment as well as our health. So very quickly, I am going to talk about the importance of our fashion industry and us in terms of our economy and the impact it has to our health and our environment, and last but not least, the things that we could do to make a change. So first, we're going to talk about the importance of this industry in our economy. According to Caroline Maloney, a U.S. congressional representative for New York's 12th district on February 2017, fashion and apparel industry employed 1.9 million people in the U.S. And fashion is a $1.2 trillion global industry with more than $250 billion spent annually on fashion in the U.S. alone, according to the industry analyst. It not only accounts for jobs of fashion designers, brand designers, manufacturer, retailer, and production labor, but also accountants, lawyers, project managers, social media director, and the list goes on. So as you can see, it holds a very important role in terms of our national as well as our global economy. And all the consumer spending that goes into this industry accounts for millions of people's livelihood. And with that said, we are going to move on to look at what impact it has to our health. Like I said earlier, in order to lower the production cost to produce more product, manufacturers often use lower quality material. And according to Jenna Amutelli, a trend reporter on Huffington Post on October 2016, consumers need to especially look out for clothing that are wrinkle resistant, static resistant, waterproof, because they undergo special chemical treatments that can be potentially harmful to us when it comes in contact with our skin. Our skin is the largest organ in our human body, and over time it can absorb chemicals that are in our clothes even after you wash it. So it's always a good idea to wash your clothes when you first bought it from the store. And additionally, according to Danny Middleton, a medical doctor and director of National Institution for Occupational Safety and Health at CDC on June 2014, dimethylformamide, DMF, a chemical found in acrylic fabric, but also in textile dye, pigment, coating, printing, and adhesive formulation, can cause liver damage, skin problems, and cancer, in particular testicular cancer. So now we know the impact it has to our health, I'm going to next talk about the impact it has to our environment. Textile waste is the second largest waste category in landfills, according to Don Kopinski, an editor on Human Footprints at National Geographic Channel on 2018. 55% of textile gets buried in landfills. And that is an overwhelming amount of waste that are produced by this industry. According to Bethany Noble, 20% of industrial water pollution in the world comes from the treatment and dyeing of textile, and about 8,000 synthetic chemicals are used to turn raw materials into textiles, such as cotton. And this causes a significant damage to our environment, because the chemicals can end up in our waters and pollute the waterway even after filtration. In particular, in China, where a large quantity of garments are produced. And with that said, that brings us to our fourth point, which is the action that we can take to make a change. So a couple things we could do. First is shop less. Don't shop just because it's on sale, it's trendy, or it's limited collection. Know what you need and buy what you need to buy what you need and not just what you want. Mm-hmm. And second, do a little research and explore fashion companies that are ethical and sustainable. And last but not least, recycle or donate your unwanted clothes, or you can also repair it, upcycle it, sell it. And one thing we could do is also promote garment recycling programs such as the one that Goodwill has or H&M has. They take your old clothes and garments and give you coupons for other purchase items. So with that said, that brings us to our conclusion. So first I talked about the importance of fashion industry in our economy. Then I talked about the impact on our health. Then I talked about the effect it has to our environment. And last but not least, the action that we can take to make a change and move towards a more sustainable fashion industry. In short, the fashion industry helps the economy significantly over the recent years. It caused damage to our health and our environment that cannot be replaced. And as it turns out, it also hurts our wallet. So, because we all know we don't actually need that many clothes. Fast fashion has took a toll on us, and now it's time for us to slow it down. Thank you.